Good day from CBS News. This is Newsbreak. Ending the U.S.-Soviet summit, President and Mrs. Reagan left Moscow, the president saying he was truly moved by his reception there. But aides on Air Force One revealed Mr. Reagan and Mikhail Gorbachev had sharply disagreed in private over wording of the communique, the U.S. rejecting Soviet language. Next stop, London. The Reagans are staying at the residence of the U.S. ambassador. Their schedule includes tea with Queen Elizabeth and dinner with Prime Minister Thatcher. Secretary of State Schultz went directly from Moscow to Brussels to report on the summit to the NATO allies. He called the Reagan-Gorbachev meeting realistic and businesslike.
If you could taste time, the sun, rain, tradition, this is what it would taste like every time. With a name like Smucker's, it has to be good.
The armored car carrying America's ambassador to Lebanon was hit by one bullet in East Beirut. Ambassador John Kelly was not hurt. Authorities say Kelly's bodyguards fired in the air to clear the road, and someone fired back, hitting the car. The head of the President's Commission on AIDS, retired Admiral James Watkins, today urged the president to declare a national public health emergency and give the Surgeon General broad power to stop the epidemic. I'm Eric Engberg, CBS News, Washington. More news later on this CBS station.
This is CBS.